So, if you haven't heard of Doki Doki Literature Club, where have you been the past 6 years? Basically, Doki Doki Literature Club is a dating sim slash psychological horror game that focuses on the four members of Unnamed School's Literature Club, and you are their newest member. I've been following the game since around 2018 or so, but I hadn't actually played it until recently, and after playing the game for myself, I don't like these designs very much. And don't get me wrong, there's a lot for people to like here. Personally, Yuri and Monica have pretty good designs to me, but I also feel like they have a lot of potential. So, I thought, I'm a character designer, let me throw my hat into the redesign ring, and throw my hat into the ring I shall. So, for each girl, I picked two sprites, one of her in her uniform and one of her in her casual outfit, because I wanted to redesign those too, because these outfits, they sure are outfits. How about we get started? The first girl I redesigned was Sayori, not only because she's the first we see in the game, but also because I had the least ideas for her. She's arguably my least favorite girl. It's not like I dislike her, it's just, you know, I'm more attached to the other girls, right? I started out by changing up her pose a little bit. I just made it a little less, back-breaking and a little bit more nervous and less cringe, I guess. I also originally wanted to do something different with her hands, but I changed it later. I also wanted to give them bags, but that didn't end up working out either. I also changed her bow into a little bunny ear headband, just because I thought it was cuter. I'm not the biggest fan of the bow. I'm not the biggest fan of most of her design, honestly. But that's why we're here, isn't it? To fix them, right? I don't know. Going into the line art, I just made her clothes a lot more messy, I guess. I think it adds a lot more to the not very put together, kind of messy look, you know? This is me trying to fix her hands. I didn't get it to work though. I originally went with the original pose. I took that L. I also messed around with giving her back her original headband just to keep that sort of character integrity, but I did give her back the bunny ear headband. I did decide that that was cuter. I just made it a little bit smaller. I made her hair a little bit more messy. I messed around with her facial expression because she looks kind of drunk. And then we get into the colors. I didn't want to make her hair like pink, how it is in the game. I actually wanted to make her like strawberry blonde. So I went with more of a blonde color just to separate her from Monica. Just because her hair color is so similar to Monica's, I didn't like that very much. I kept her eyes blue because that's iconic. I thought they looked really good blue. Added nice contrast. There's me messing with the hands again, trying to make it work. I didn't make it work. I dulled the red a little bit, just because that bright red is really harsh, so I made it a little less saturated. I was trying to think about the reasons that I didn't like Sayori as much as I liked the other girls, and I think it's because she has the most missed potential with her writing. Like, with her having depression, I think that there was a lot that could have been done with it, but because she's the girl we spend the least time with, she didn't have as much of a chance to shine, so I didn't get to spend as much time with her, so I don't think I was as emotionally attached to her as I was to the other three, which is really a shame, because, like I said, I think she has a lot of potential. But I also, you know, I find her a little bit annoying, but maybe that's just me projecting onto her. I do see a lot of myself in her. So I tried to give her a pose that was more, you know, sincere, I guess I would call it. With her casual outfit. Ooh, okay. One thing I will say about this casual outfit is that I like the color scheme. I really like the pink with the blue. I think that's really cute. And I picked the sprite just because I think that it's really off-putting to me, so I wanted to make it less off-putting and more genuinely cute and innocent. I gave her the band-aid on her nose. And with her hair, I tried to make it more fluffy. All of the girls have really flat hair, which I'm not the biggest fan of, and I think it doesn't fit very well with Sayori. I gave her curly hair. I just felt it in my soul. She needed it. I think I fixed it a little bit more later, but my goal here was to try to make her a little less stick thin, take away her thigh gap. I just thought, I thought it added a little something something, you know? For her outfit, I knew I had to give her overalls. They were just too cute. So I went on Pinterest and I found an outfit I really liked. I kept this kind of 3/4 length pink shirt. I just gave it a little bit more of a sweater texture. I thought that would be really cute. And I tried to keep the colors the same. I lightened the blue a little bit. I gave her the red headband. And I just, looking at it now, it's giving Elizabeth Afton, which was not my intention. But I didn't realize this while I was drawing it, so. Another little detail I added was I painted her nails. They're rainbow. I thought that was really cute. I also wanted to give all the girls last names. So here she is. Here's Sayori Ueda. Yuri is my personal favorite. She's my best girl, as 2017 as that statement is. But because she's my favorite, there wasn't much I wanted to change about her. One thing I did change, though, was her body type. Having such a large chest does not normally come with as thin of a waist, so I filled out her body a little bit more. I thought it was more realistic. I made her face a little bit more mature, in my opinion. It's mostly just the art style that makes them look all a little bit younger, but I wanted her to have a bit more of a mature look. I gave her a more prominent nose. I thought that was gorgeous. I thought that was really pretty. But I didn't change very much. I also gave her earrings. You can't see it here, but I painted her nails black. I know that Japanese schools don't normally let you customize your uniform, like adding earrings or painting your nails or anything like that, but this is my video. Natsuki's hair is literally pink, so I can do whatever I want. I know that Doki Doki Literature Club is not your standard dating sim, so you don't get as much time with the rest of the girls as you do with Monica, but I wish we had more Yuri content. I want to learn more about her. I want to learn more about this world that they live in. I just want to know more about her, you know? Getting into the coloring, I made her a little bit more pale, and I gave her rosy cheeks and hands just to make her look cold, I guess I could call it. I made her hair a little less saturated, less of a purple and more of a dark blue. I do change that later to make it more dark and less purple. I wanted to lean more towards blue. I just thought it fit her a little better. And I also made her eyes blue. That's the one big change in this design. I made her eyes like a pale blue. I thought it made her look a lot more mysterious. Other than that, I just kind of gave her hair more of a blunt cut at the bottom. That's about it for the uniform. For her casual outfit, I picked the sprite of her playing with her hair because it is so cute. I love her so much. I have a lot of opinions on this outfit. It is something that I would have worn in fourth grade. The sweaters over leggings, that is me in fourth grade. So I turned the sweater into a cardigan, and I wanted to give her a kind of a long dress because I thought it would be really cute. I thought it'd fit her really well. Count how many times I say cute in this video. Yuri is undoubtedly my favorite just because I think she's really complex. Like, obviously Monica is complex because she's supposed to be sentient, but Yuri isn't sentient. But I still think that she has some of the most depth out of the four characters we get in this game. And I think that's really impressive because we don't spend a lot of time with her. We don't spend a lot of time with any of them. Because, I mean, it's a pretty short game, but what we do get of Yuri, I think, is really interesting. She's into reading, she's quiet, her writing style is really interesting. I love her so much, what can I say? And I know being deep and mysterious is her whole thing. She's like, oh, I'm so deep, I'm so mysterious, but I like it, okay? I like her, I love her, I love her, okay? For the outfit, I kept this kind of cream color for the cardigan, but I made the dress like a navy because not only did I think it added a lot of contrast, I just thought that it was pretty. I think that cream and this navy blue, I think it's very pretty. I think it's very pretty. Other than that, I don't have a lot else to say about her. Yeah. Here is Yuri Nanako. I think it was originally supposed to be Nakano, but I messed up. That's my bad. Sorry. I'm not gonna lie. Natsuki was really difficult at first. I knew she'd be the most difficult. She's just really not my style. But I actually had a lot of fun with her, more than I was expecting to, at least. Her body type was a little difficult for me. I'm not really used to drawing super skinny characters, and also translating her face into my style was kind of difficult, but I think I managed it. I think she looks really cute. You'll watch me struggle with both the body and the hair before I find something that I like. Her pose was also really difficult. I'm not used to drawing characters with their arms folded, so she was just overall really difficult, but honestly, she turned out my favorite in the end. You'll see what I'm talking about. Here you can see me messing with her hair. Once again, I wasn't a big fan of her having really flat hair, so I gave her different bangs. Well, you'll see me trying a bunch of different styles, but her original hairstyle is just so iconic and I feel like it fits her really well. So I just gave her a little bit of a different hair texture. I made it a bit more wavy. And I also gave it a kind of a blunt cut at the end, like I did with Yuri. I tied it up, I gave her different bangs, and I think it turned out really cute. I really like this style. I also played around with like space buns, but I just kept the pigtails. For her outfit, you can't really see it yet because I haven't colored it, but I actually gave her a vest instead of the blazer. I thought that maybe it would add a bit more diversity in their outfits, especially when they're in their uniforms. And I thought it fit her a little bit better so she could roll up her sleeves. I thought that'd be pretty cute. But you'll see it more when I color it. I also gave her freckles, like I did for Sayori, and I made her eyes gold. I'm not a really big fan of when characters have the same eye color and hair color. I don't think it looks very good. And I kept her hair pink, but I actually made her roots blonde. I changed them from brown to blonde in a second. Maybe like her hair needs a bit of a touch up. She hasn't dyed it in a little bit. I also painted her nails like a dark pink red to match her ribbons, and that's pretty much it for her uniform. I gave her some cute earrings too. For her casual outfit, I'm gonna be so honest, I do not like her original. I don't like any of their original casual outfits, but I like hers the least. I think it just screams, it's my first day of second grade. So I wanted to give her something that was still really cute, but wasn't something an 8-year-old would wear. I see her as that friend who's really into Sanrio. She has a bunch of My Melody and Hello Kitty outfits and merch and things like that. Oh, and I changed her pigtails to space buns in this outfit just so I could get the buns in there somewhere. And I thought they fit really well. They look like little hearts. I kept her shirt mostly the same. I added an undershirt under it and changed the ruffled skirt to a pleated skirt. I thought it was a lot cuter. I added some more little barrettes in her hair. She was pretty easy, actually. Her casual outfit, at least. She was a lot easier than I thought she'd be, which I'm grateful for. Anyways, here is Natsuki Kusumoto. I'm very happy with her. If I thought Natsuki was going to give me a lot of trouble, I did not know what was in for me, because Monika was probably the most difficult, mainly because I think her design is already as good as it gets. Like, I love her. I love her design. I love the ponytail. I love the ribbon. I love how she's just staring directly at the camera. I actually drew her looking off to the side because I thought it'd be less off-putting, until I remembered she's supposed to be off-putting. She's supposed to look out of place. So you'll see in a second that I change her. I make it to where she's looking back at the camera again. But I didn't change a lot about her. This is pretty much just me drawing her in my style. I didn't change anything about her because her design is already so good to me. Like, out of all four of the girls, I think she has the strongest design. One thing I did change, though, that you'll see in a second when I start coloring, is that I made her hair a little bit more brown. A lot of people do that when they draw fan art of Doki Doki Literature Club. They make Monika's hair less pink and more brown. And it says on the wiki that her hair is supposed to be coral brown, but you color drop it and it's literally just pink. This is pink. With the shading it looks brown, but it is technically like a reddish pink. So I just made it a little bit more orangey brown. I thought it fit more with her, contrasted her eyes really well. But that is about it for Monika's uniform. And you may be saying, Lucky, that's my name. by the way. I'm lucky, if you didn't know. Monica doesn't have a casual outfit. What is there to redesign? And I hear you. She doesn't exist outside of the literature club, so she's not supposed to have a casual outfit. But one of her voice lines in Act 3 says she wishes she could have worn some cute clothes for us. And that's so cute. So I'm giving the people what they deserve, what they need. And I'm giving Monica a cute casual outfit. I think she deserves it. I looked up what other people had done for a casual outfit for Monica, and I didn't like any of them, so I went my own way. I think she's a sweater vest girly. I just feel it in my heart. I feel it in my heart, and she has a cute little skirt with a button up under it, and she's super cute, very, very put together, very neat. She knows she lays out her clothes the night before just so that she knows what she's gonna wear the next day. She's just like that. Honestly, I'm sure somebody has made this already, but I need a mod where you can romance Monica because I love her. She and Yuri, they have my heart. Natsuki and Sayori are in there as well, but Monica and Yuri, they have my heart. They own it. Here's Monica. And that is all four of our girlies. Hey, this part isn't scripted, but thank you so much for watching my first video. I'm really proud with how it's come out. I've been working on this for a really long time. It's been my dream to be an art YouTuber for as long as I can remember, so I really appreciate you taking time out of your day to watch my first video. I'm really happy with how these designs came out, and I hope you are too. I'd really like some critique on my editing, my art, anything that you want to tell me. So please leave a comment, tell me how your day is going, tell me what you thought of the video. The original idea I had for my first video was actually redesigning Genshin characters, but that turned out to be a little bit more difficult than I thought it would be, so tune in next time for that one. That'll be the next video I post. Until then, I've been Inkyo, and I will see you very soon!